This video will show you how to perform a Progeny Vantage panoramic cephalometric exam. Before conducting any clinical procedure, service, or maintenance operations, always refer to the appropriate technical documentation for the complete list of instructions, safety alerts, and sequence of procedures. The following steps will be covered in this video. First, choose the appropriate Ceph functions. Second, explain the exam to the patient. Third, properly position the patient. And last, acquire the image. To begin, tap the projection button on the top right of the Vantage Touch control screen to select the Ceph function. Verify the technique factors according to patient size and anatomy. Next, determine the Ceph study needed for the patient and select desired function. To do this, there are three cephalostat functions, which are the AP, the image taken from the anterior to the posterior of the head, or nasion toward the tube head, PA, the image taken from the posterior to the anterior of the head, nasion opposite the tube head, and lateral left or lateral right. The otic posts are in line with the X-ray tube head. Rotate the cephalostat to the proper position based on the desired function or study type. Rotating the cephalostat will automatically configure the system for the chosen cephalometric study type. Now that the Ceph function is chosen, explain the examination to the patient. Use a sanitary wipe or barrier on the nasion marker and place the ear speculums on the otic posts. Explain where the patient will stand under the cephalometric attachment. Ask the patient to remove glasses and mouth or facial piercings, as well as a jacket or bulky sweater. You should now ready the machine for imaging to be in the patient entry position. To begin the image acquisition, tap the Ready for Imaging button on the touch control panel. The status indicator flashes Wait to indicate a moving status while the Vantage system moves to the ready position. Once the Vantage system is ready to perform a scan, the status indicator will change to Green Ready State. With the patient standing next to the unit, visually compare the height of the patient's otic canal with the cephalostat ear posts. Adjust the height of the cephalostat until the ear posts are approximately the height of the patient's otic canal. Grasp the otic posts at the top and move it out to position the patient. The posts are designed so that they will not move except when grasped at the top. Next, rotate the nasion marker up and help the patient to enter the Ceph. Using the up-down control buttons on the secondary collimator or on the side of the patient positioning table, adjust the height of the Vantage system until the ear posts are approximately level with the patient's otic canal. Grasp the nasion and slide it vertically until it aligns with the bridge of the patient's nose. Slide the nasion toward the patient's nose until the tip contacts the bridge of the nose. For projections where the nasion is not needed, it will rotate about the base out of the projection area. The patient's head position should be reviewed to make sure it is correct along three axes. From a side lateral view, the Frankfurt plane, bottom of orbit to otic posts, should be level horizontally. From a frontal view, the patient's face should be straight forward without any twisting. Also from the front, ensure the patient's head is not tilted, but vertically straight. With the patient properly positioned, ask the patient to close their mouth, take a deep breath and swallow, place their tongue on the roof of their mouth, then remain as motionless as possible until the device stops moving and they are instructed on what to do next. Step back at least 2 meters, 6 feet, away from the Vantage system, but not toward the patient, and press and hold the exposure button until the Vantage system stops moving. When the image preview appears on the touch control panel, release the exposure button and verify the image acquired is the one desired for the patient. Tap OK to close the image window. If the exposure button is released before the Vantage system stops moving, the message "Procedure was interrupted before completion" appears. Click OK on the message window and wait for the Vantage system to recover and to determine if the image preview appears. 1. If it does, verify the accuracy of the image. 2. If there is no image or the displayed one is inaccurate, retake the image. Release the patient from the cephalometric by rotating the nasion up and pushing out the otic wands. Help the patient exit the Vantage system. For more detailed information about how to perform a cephalometric examination, please refer to the Progeny Vantage Panoramic X-ray System User Guide. For further support, contact Midmark Support Services at 1-800-MIDMARK or visit www.midmark.com.